She put through a call to Loversley, only to be told that Mr. Hayward had gone to London. And after a moment's thought, she said, "Will you telephone a message he will get on arriving at his office? It's simply that what I told him this morning is cancelled." With intelligent precision, the butler repeated the words of the message, and she felt at peace. The man was an excellent servant, but she, Laura, did not like him, for she knew what neither his master nor mistress suspected, that he was very fond of money. She was convinced that it was he who had given a Sunday paper certain titbits of gossip concerning the courtship of Fordish Dowsland that no one else was in a position to supply. Chapter 9. When he reached the house, Mark learnt that his parents had gone out together for a stroll. They were seldom parted even for as long as an hour, and sometimes their son would smilingly complain that he found it difficult to see either his father or mother alone. He walked through into what was called the long parlour of Malcolm Court. It was a singular-looking apartment, though a most comfortable and charming living room, with noble views of the sea and coastline. The walls were closely covered with paintings, engravings, miniatures, and even photographs connected with the Scruton family. Everything there, even to the chairs, of which the covers in petit pois had been worked by a great aunt, ministered to that feeling of ancestor worship which seems inherent in human, and more especially in British, nature. Even Mark, though he would not have liked to admit it to himself, was quite as proud as was his old soldier father that he came of a stock which had served king, queen, and country for what seemed to him countless generations. Often he gazed with inward pleasure at the portrait hanging over the fireplace in this long parlour, of the Scruton who had been among the West Countrymen who had sailed with Raleigh from Plymouth Hoe. He couldn't help being glad that the woman who would, in days to come, reign here as his cherished wife was, by birth, a Dulburton of Dulburton, of ancient Yorkshire stock.